Will S. Green was a major part of creating the opportunity for irrigation in the Sacramento Valley, and he spent decades trying to promote and create an irrigation system. He had far-reaching vision, and this award is something that can be presented to people who are looking at the big picture.
Well, Sandy is absolutely worthy of the Will Green Award.
I think it's exciting that she gets this award because I think it's almost like a fruition of what Will S. Green was originally thinking about back in the day. So for her to get the award, I think is completely appropriate, and you know, I'm sure he would be giving her a thumbs up as well.
Will Green was a pioneer and a leader and a visionary, and she fits all those categories just great.
She has done so much in her time in water throughout the state.
Well, of course, who else would be better or more deserving of that award than Sandy?
She's like one of the top two or three people that came to my mind. It's like, that's somebody who needs that award. It fits her.
Sandy's always kind of been a visionary. I look at the things she's done just on her own farm and ranch, and I think she's ahead of her time in terms of the things that they've been doing, dealing with sustainability, how to farm, how to improve things for the environment.
She has a huge amount of energy, and she's very committed to whatever she's involved in.
Water is in her bones, and she's got a desire to fix things, but she has also a really important skill set, which is knowing that you got to understand a problem before you can fix it.
She was always fair, firm, and looked out for the best interests of the district.
She gets it. She's passionate about farming, but she's also very passionate about the wildlife that the Sacramento Valley farming provides and supports, like the waterfowl in particular.
Sandy volunteered an awful lot to do things that other folks didn't want to do in terms of joining committees representing the district as the district's representative in a whole bunch of stuff.
Not only is she very busy in the water world and in an ag policy world, but you know, she went back and got a law degree here recently. I mean, it's pretty amazing. That's something I wouldn't want to do.
Not because she was ever going to practice law, but because she wanted to understand the issue that really drove her to it.
Whether it's in water or on a hunting trip, she is always out for the fun and the game of the business.
Her presence and kind of calming and exciting at the same time, this position will be missed, and not just in the Sacramento Valley, but I would say throughout the Central Valley and throughout the West.
I think just her thinking and leadership has encouraged others. I know for me, she's really helped me and educated me on how to look at things here in the Valley and what we need to do, and I think without that, it would be a different place.